material gain is not there for the spiritual people to get spiritual gain and society gain. Because of lack of coordination. So that is the thing. So you must be ready for any language, you must be ready for any place, you must be ready for any number of times. That type of unfading zeal is the primary medulla oblongata, it is the primary spirit for conducting the spiritual journey. It is either socialization of spiritualism or spiritualization of socialism. These things are possible only by this zeal. Azure zeal. This is very much required. Then translation. Then the fifth thing is propagation. If you just give books, those things are insufficient. It must have dynamic people, it must have talented people, it must have people, those who are skillful in power of elocution, the power of oration and articulation, the power of permeation and penetration into the hearts of the people, minds of the people, the power of fraternity and bondage to create in the society, which creates love, dependence and loyalty, making everybody absorbable into the mechanism. Isn't it so? So these things are very much essential. This is known as vision. What is vision? Continuously doing a thing without a break, pass, diversion, dilution or dilapidation till you get the goal, preserve the goal and sustain the goal is vision. And the vision is collection, orderly presentation, then simplification, translation and propagation. Why it is known as century? Because 2 millennia totally the degradation was mainly caused by various factors. One is invasion, second is migration, third thing is trade, fourth thing is colonization, and fifth thing is involvement of the people. There were 3 things. One is kala, second is the shastra, third thing is shruti. Shruti is contemplation of God. Shastra, they are all compound skills which are meant for supporting the Vedas, like tarka, logics, vyakarana, grammar, nirukta, etymology, prasodi, chanda, jyotisha, astronomy. All of these things are limbs. They are known as shastras. And kala is music, dance, sculpture, literature, etc. And shruti is contemplation of divine energy. Somebody asked the question, why India was invaded by lot of people? Where your gods or where your people, saints, where had they been? Then we told that locally, the society was diluted or they have been diverted to shastras and kalas, and only the least members of the society were concerned about shrutis. So Shruti is a divinity and Shastra and Kala, they deal with something science and odd sections of the Vedas. That is a major diversion for the reason of all of these things. So we have to bring back the Shruti. So more than 20 centuries, the debilitation of the spiritual vigor, the consolidation and concentration, that has been diluted by means of diversion, invasion, colonization, imperialism, inner clashes, the general bio-geo-degradation of the Kali impact. So all of these things totally they contributed for a total loss of them. So now we are having a lot of facilities. So according to Shastras of cause and effect, the Karya-Karana Bandha, for 2000 years, for 20 centuries of degradation, certainly you have taken more than 4 or 5 centuries. But now Kali is also a blessing in disguise, that we are having lot of various methodologies of propaganda like electronic media, print media, simplification, lot of other supporting tools are there. Moreover, the people are already in distress, disappointment and depression. So it is very easy for us to go in that track, utilizing the electronic and print media and to get the proper way of propaganda, like military propaganda, like intelligence propaganda, knowing about the mentality. So we must milk the cow, which is submissive to dance and which is submissive to song, and that is a saying, there is a proverb in Tamil. So that which is prone to song and that which is subservient to dance, those things have to be milked on their own way. So understanding psychology, understanding sociology is very much essential for propagation. So theosophy, sociology and psychology are like 3 eyes of a propagator. And even though theology or philosophy is not there, as the other 2 things are there with the Christian missionaries, they have succeeded. They know sociology, they know psychology. What is the trend of the society? What is the proclivity of these individuals? So they used to handle it very perfectly, and it is not their personal intellectual property, right? Anybody can handle that. With the help of theosophy, philosophy, epistemology, etymology, entology, ontology, teleology, agatology, erismatology, then tomatology, aritology, eschatology, ontology, cosmology, cosmopolitan, any further with more values hidden in our shastras with the benefit of immaculate, that is ever showering wisdom, inexhaustible wisdom, we can handle also psychological instincts and sociological factors to get into proper value of propagation. That is the century mission. So these 20 centuries of degradation, it will take at least 5 generations to get into a proper cure or perfect cleanliness. This perfect, absolute, consummate cleanliness will happen after only 5 generations. So it is known as century mission. So we have defined what is India, what is mission, India's mission and India's century mission. Now God has created everything. He has manifested everything from his belly, and according to Shastras, he sucks everything at the time of cosmic dissolution. So whenever he spits it, it is known as creation. But at the time of creation, he makes only a preliminary creation. He does not give any form or structure or composition. He creates all the ingredients and he has gifted us discretion, the power to desire and to use. So discretion starts with determination. Determination ends in curiosity. Curiosity gives you creativity. Creativity blossoms into innovative temper. Innovative temper results in formation of various things. So this is how God has created a balanced way of the species and space. The space being unprocessed and species, especially the advanced species of human being, given the courage, given the capability, given the competence by his discretion, by his discrimination, by his determination, how to process these raw ingredients and to give you full form. So this is known as formation. The first manifestation is known as creation. Then the human being, he undertakes the second grade of creation, which is formation. In the course of formation, due to degradation of the principles of ethicism and morality, it will be subjected to deformation by means of negligence or ignorance or arrogance. This deformation occurs at the time of with great stalwarts, great personalities, rise to put it in the own form, repatriate to the own form, that is known as reformation. So creation, formation, deformation and reformation. These are all the various stages of journey in the processing the world and its actions. Likewise, we are now going to deal with reforms. So reforms means already that which has been formed for the welfare of the society at large, which has been deformed by negligence, ignorance and arrogance, misappropriation of people, that like-minded personalities, committed personalities, personalities who are the embodiment of sensitivity, loyalty and sacrifice, those people, now we are going to make a conceptualization, visualization and implementation of those tenets to reform the society which is deformed. So if it is deformed, why it is deformed? Because there are some beneficiaries for deformations. From deformation, a lot of people are getting the benefits. If you are subjected to disease, you may be feeling uneasy. But that is the easiest and luxurious position for those microbes or germs that are causing the disease. It may be dis-ease for you, but it is the position of luxury for the germs inside. Likewise, those who are the parasites of the formation and precision of the society, those people, they will enjoy a lot of benefits and they will be very potential. We have to just counter them and get back the position into reformation or the originality. Now there are four major things, innumerable things are there to stay. There are only four major things: education, economy, administration and electoral reforms. Everything starts with education. All our process should start with education. For knowledge inculcation, you must start with education. For implementation, it must end with political reforms, because administration system is having the power and education system is having the capability to instill. So everything, any reform system should start with education and end with power. If it does not start with education, it cannot blossom. If it does not end with power, it won't be beneficial to the society, it will be futile. So for instillation, education is the beginning point, and the surrendering point, the ultimate point is politics for fructification, instillation and fructification. Number one, education is the beginning point, I have already told. And education consists of four steps, I want to say. And the absence of any step that will result in education to be called as partial blindness.